My name is Scott Hoover. I am Lead Online Marketing Specialist at Miles Technologies, and today I'm going to show you how to set up an analytics dashboard that'll give you a good glance as to how your website is performing. First step is you need to log into your analytics account, and then you'll see something like this here, which gives you the audience overview. On the upper corner here, you'll see a tab called Dashboards. You'll click to expand it, and then you'll click the plus new dashboard button to create your new dashboard. In here, we'll give it a name, and we'll just say website metrics. And then we're going to start with a blank canvas here. You can choose the starter dashboard, and that'll give you some overall metrics. However, I like to start with a blank canvas so I can customize it to the specific metrics that I want to see at a glance. From here, you click the Create Dashboard button, and now it's going to ask you to add your first widget. So first one, the first category that I would recommend is just overall traffic. So in this case, we'll call this total traffic, and then here we'll select a timeline so we can see what our traffic looks like over a period of time. We're going to click the Add a Metric button, and then in here we're going to just start typing in the word users, and you can see it shows up, and we're going to click on the entry users, and from here we're just going to click Save. So now we have a widget that just shows our total traffic. Next, we're going to click Add Widget again, and this time I want to see total sessions just as a number, not as a timeline. So we're going to type in total sessions here, and we're going to leave this metric button selected, and from the metric drop-down we're going to begin typing the word sessions and scroll down to the sessions entry. We're going to click Save, and now we have the total number of users coming to the website over a period of time, and then the total number of sessions, so the number of visits that we have here. I also want to see just the total number of users that have come to the website over this period of time. And so again, I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to select total users, type that in, leave metric selected, and then down here in the drop-down I'm just going to begin to type users, and again select the same thing that we did for the graph. The only difference this time is that we're just going to get a number, not a timeline to show users over time. So here we have users, and so over this period of time we've had 6,346 users totaling 9,020 sessions. So what this is telling us is that users have visited the page more than once, or the website more than once. So from here I'd like to see just the total page views. So this is the total number of pages that have been viewed by these 6,346 users. So I'm going to type in total page views right here, and again leaving the metric, and then from the drop down we're going to select, begin typing page views, and click on the entry. Hit the save button, and now we have the total number of page views. So we have this information down here. Next, we should probably see the number of pages per session. Now you can do that by dividing the page views by the sessions, however, so you don't have to do any manual work. We'll just have the system do the calculation for us. So I will just type in here average pages per session, and again we're leaving metric selected, and from the metric drop-down we're going to select average, actually it'll just be pages per session, here it is in the drop-down, and then we'll hit save, and then now we have the average pages per session here available to us. We'll drop it down here, and then the last traffic metric that I think we should look at from a number standpoint is the average session duration. So this tells us how long each visit to the website generally lasts on average. So we'll call this average session duration, And we're going to leave this as a metric. And then here, I'll type in session duration, and you'll see there's a calculation done for that as well called average session duration. And from the drop down, let's drag it down here to the bottom. So now this is our traffic column area over here. Now another good thing for people to have is the traffic by source. So this is by source, what we mean is what is the origination of the user coming to your website. Did they see you in organic search results? Did they see you in a paid advertisement? Maybe they clicked on a link on another website that ends up coming to your website, so that would be a referral. So it's good to get a good breakdown of where people are finding you. So we'll call this one here traffic by source. And then we're actually going to select the pie graph here, and I'll tell you in a minute why the pie graph is the best selection for this one. So I selected pie, and then you'll see we actually have another option down here. So the first one under metric, we're going to type in sessions. So these are visits. And then we're going to group them by the dimension source. And so we're going to choose source here. And then from there, we'll leave it, we'll leave this as 5 slices. Generally, there's probably not going to be more than that, so we'll leave it at that. And then let's drag it over here so we have a little bit of a, better view of things at a glance here. So the reason why I chose pie is because it gives you a nice visual to show you, the different breakdowns of the traffic sources. What I also like is that when you hover over this in the analytics dashboard, it actually gives you the exact number. So you can see here we have an exact number, 5895 sessions, or 65.4% coming from Google. So this is where we're going to see that data right here. And then another good one is looking at traffic by device. So if you want to know how many people and the breakdown of people coming to your website via a desktop computer or laptop or a tablet or a cell phone or mobile device, so we're going to type this one in here as traffic by device. Again, we're going to choose the pie graph because we're seeing a nice breakdown. Under the metric, we're going to select sessions, and under the dimension, we're going to group it by device category. You can actually get more specific with the device information. So if you wanted to be a little bit more specific as to which make and model of device and not just the device category, you're going to select the mobile device info, and that'll give you usually the model and the make and sometimes the version or operating system that they're using. But in this case, it's good just to have an overall view of the category. Now we only have 3 different categories here, so I'll leave 5, but there's only really 3 categories that will show up in this graph. And so again, we will drag this underneath here. And now you can see the breakdown of device. So, we're seeing not only the percentages, but also the actual numbers when we hover over these slices of the pie here. So the last thing that you should really have on here is your conversions or your goals. If you don't have goal or conversion tracking set up, I'll show you in a different video how to set those things up, but here this will give you a good idea about how many people are converting on your website, whether it's a form submission or it could be some sort of event or something that users have done on the website. So I'll show you here, we'll just measure maybe overall total conversions. For this specific example here, I already have some form submissions set up as goals, so we'll just be looking at those. So I'm going to call this one here total conversions. We're going to leave metric selected, and then under the metric dropdown, we're going to type in goal completions. And there we are right here. So this is giving me the total number of goal completions. In this case, it's form submissions. So we have 421 total form submissions here. Actually, I'm going to drag it over here underneath here. So another thing I want to know is the conversion rate. What is the ratio of people coming to the website who actually fill out the forms on the website? So I'm going to call this one here conversion rate. And then leaving metrics selected, under the drop-down, we're going to select goal conversion rate. And then I'm going to hit save. And then here we can see the conversion rate is a little over 4.5%, which is a good conversion rate to have. So I'm just going to drag this down here and put it below the total number of conversions here. The next thing I think we should look at is the conversions by device, so seeing if there's any different types of devices that are converting better than others. So again, we can get very specific on the device type, or we can just look at the device category. In this case, we're going to look at the category. So I'm going to say conversions by device type. And again, we're going to select the pie because we want to see the breakdown of the device type. And in the metric dropdown, we'll select goal completions again. And then in the dimension dropdown, we're going to select device category. And again, we only have three categories, so we'll leave that at 5 slices. And now we can see the different breakdowns of where people are converting from based on their device type. So for this specific example, 3/4 of the conversions come from a desktop, 22% coming from mobile, and then a little bit less than 3% coming from tablets. So let's say we want to see a specific conversion type. So let's say I want to see not only the total conversions of all the forms, but maybe I have one form that I want to keep an eye on. So for this example, we're going to choose the request a quote form submission. So I'm going to type this one in here as RFQ submissions. We're going to leave this as metric again. And then under the dropdown, we're going to type in the name of the goal that I called it. In this case, it's called get a quote. So get a quote. And then I'm going to look for in the parentheses that says completions. We have other metrics that we can measure, but in this case, I just want to see how many goal completions or form submissions we have. So I select that, and then I hit save. And then I see here that we have 9 of them. And again, I'm just going to drop this down here to all of the other conversion section. So that's how you're going to set up the dashboard for your analytics account. And another thing that you can do is actually export this. So if you wanted to export the data that you see here, you can export it to a PDF. You can also set up an automated email. And what the automated email will do is that will send an email on a basis, on a recurring basis that you select with these metrics embedded into them, almost like a PDF. So you can just type in john@gmail.com, whatever the recipient's email address is. And then from here, you can select the frequency that they receive it, whether it's just a one-time deal, you can send it on a daily, weekly, monthly, or quarterly basis. I generally recommend at the most you look at it monthly and maybe at the average on a weekly basis. From there, you can select a time of the week, so whatever day you want. And then under the advanced options, you can set an expiration date on here as well. And then you'll just hit the send button, and that'll automatically schedule these emails. Be sure to check to see which date range you have selected in the upper right-hand corner here, as this will dictate what metrics are showing up here and what are set up in the automated email before you actually save it. Thank you for your time.